And all across the nation for the past 4 years, the little preacher has been going up and down, winning lost humanity with the message of the Master. At this time, let me introduce to you little Marjoe.
Howdy, neighbors. May the Lord bless you.
When I would go to a press conference or an interview, my father would march me in full outfit right up to the news editor and say, I want to see the editor. They would be so shocked at a six-year-old kid coming up with a full handshake. And I would say, you know, how do you do, Mr. Smith? My name is Marjoe Gortner. I'm in town to give the devil two black eyes. The guy is falling out of his seat, and he would say something back like, you're a minister? Yes, that's right. The Lord called me to preach when I was 4 years old. Do you memorize your sermons? Absolutely not. You know, I get them in my sleep. Sometimes I get them while I'm driving down the road. But they all come from God. The name Marjoe is a combination of Mary and Joseph. When I was born, it was really a miracle because I was born by cesarean. And when they opened up my mother, the cord was wrapped around my neck 3 times, so I guess I did start off with a legitimate miracle.
At this time, I would like to present to you the world's youngest ordained minister and the world's youngest evangelist, Marjoe Gortner. Marjoe started preaching when he was 3 and a half. Today is Marjoe's 8th.
I remember my mother going through very, correctional activities, you might say, to get me prepared to say the wedding ceremony, because I had to recite the whole Episcopal ceremony verbatim and write my name on the certificate. I'm not sure, but I think they had, you know, a preaching number planned for me, coming from such a long background of preachers, and my mother being a very flamboyant evangelist. As a child, I'd want to go out and play, and we'd have to spend hours and hours, you know, memorizing. And my mind would slip. Finally, my mother would begin to lose her patience with me, and she would put a pillow over my head, maybe, and smother me for a little bit. Other times, she'd hold me under the water faucet, but she never wanted to put any marks on my body because she knew I had to be in front of the press, and so she'd never hit me or anything.
I thank God for my darling Christian mother that pointed me to Jesus. If we had more good Christian mothers that would teach the boys of the world how to play more instead of drinking cocktails and smoking filthy old cigarettes, we would have a better America, better men and women, and not so much juvenile delinquency.
There would be, you know, gestures like when I would say Jesus, my arms would have to go out, to when I would say the devil, I would go forward. And she had this incredible set of signals. They were like, if she would say, oh Jesus, if I was going too slow, or if she said glory to God, you know, that meant you better speed up and go a little bit faster. Then later on they came up with more signals, like praise God meant, you know, you've got the people where you need them, you better take an offering and raise some money. And I had an ego, you know, and I enjoyed the people and I enjoyed the attention that I was getting. I remember I really enjoyed, everyone was very nice to me, and my reaction to it, like I didn't understand, I can't really think of a time that I ever believed in God or in, you know, and I've ever thought that it was a miracle of God that I preached. I don't think, even with all the people gathering around me, you know, thousands of people saying this has to be a miracle, surely, you know, God has called you and all that. I don't think with all that, I just, you know, knew that I could do it well and my parents had trained me, but I never really tripped out and thought that I was some real miracle child of any kind.
My, I can just see Jesus on his way up. Hallelujah. Going up into the sky. I'm going up. Hallelujah. And I can see him as he starts to go up. My. And what does the Bible say when he got up there? Praise God. He sat down. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. Whenever you hear of a high priest sitting down, that means that his work is finished. Hallelujah. So when Jesus sat down, brother, the Holy Ghost had to get up. Oh, yes, he did. Hallelujah. I see that Holy Ghost as it begins to come down. I see those 120 people as they make their way up into the upper room. Oh, hallelujah. They shut the windows. They locked the doors for fear of their lives. But I see them as they got down on their knees and they began to pray. And I see the Holy Ghost as cloven tongues of fire were upon them. Hallelujah. And oh, my, the Holy Ghost finally found a permanent resting place.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He won. wants a permanent resting place in your life. As some people, you see, they've taken these prayer cloths for their son or their daughter who is in drugs or dope addiction. And they've given that prayer cloth to them, and I've had many testimony of a young person after they got one of these prayer cloths, they were delivered from drugs. How many believe that God can work this way? Do you believe it? Praise the Lord. I want you to get out the largest bill that you have right now. If you believe, if you don't have that much faith, then you shouldn't come down anyhow. Even young people, anyone who wants to come down, if you want to believe for someone in your life, I want you just to give. If it's a $20 bill is the largest bill you got, then I want you to get that out. If it's a 10, I want you to get that out. If it's only a dollar bill, I want you to get that out. But I'm asking you to prove God with whatever the largest offering that you have tonight. Anyone else who wants to right now, stand to your feet. All right, I want you to make your way. And as I lay hands on you tonight, I want us to sing that chorus, "There's Victory in Jesus," by the key of A or A flat. Hallelujah. Everyone sing, "Well, I've got victory in Jesus, my Savior forever."
Listen to me. Every one of us got an ache. Every one of us got a pain. Every one of us got trouble, sorrow, heartaches, whatever it is. Joe, I believe with you saying, "I'm so glad that Jesus set me free." He'll loosen that leg of yours up in that knee. Hallelujah. God will loosen these joints. Arthritis will go. Hallelujah. Come on. Dope will go. Narcotics will leave you. Sin will go out of your life. I want everybody that you want something from God.
Sound, boy.
Thank you. Coming from you, I think that's a compliment.
Find out
where that dove went.
Boy, that climax on that dove was it. I like that.
I got that when I was down in Texas. You know Fitzgerald?
Yeah, well, Fitzgerald.
I preached that the first time in his church.
You count the big stuff, and I'll count this.
Okay. You gonna trust me?
Oh, I think I'll trust you.
Okay. 20, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 25.
You sure won't put it straight.
I said, "Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Thank you, Jesus. Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Jesus is so good to me tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I praise the Lord. Oh, glory, glory. Hallelujah. I feel good in my soul." Praise the Lord. Oh. Sure isn't as heavy as it used to be, though, in the old days. Wow. Really heavy then.
I can remember how I used to have to go down and work with my mother and father, the whole thing, money, from the time I was 4 years. I really supported them, you know, when I was a child, come to think about it. I remember how they used to send me down into the aisles, and I wore these little velvet pants and Lord Fauntleroy suits with satin shirts, but my mother would sew like extra pockets into the suit so that I could stuff money. And they would announce tonight, now everyone tonight that gives $20, little Marjorie's gonna come down and give you a kiss. All these little lovely old ladies that wanted to get their fingers in my little curly locks. Then after I'd fill up my pockets, I'd come back and my father would alleviate me of the money. I don't even remember what town it was in exactly, but all I remember is he took off. We were in a meeting. He left a note. He preached the meeting one night, and if I remember right, I think he took the offering too. I don't know how much came in. As far as I can guess, maybe about $3 million from the time I was 4 to 14. And I have no idea what happened to that money. I know that I never saw it, or I never got any piece of it for my education.
This is a business, and you know, you don't get meetings or you don't get booked back unless you have a gimmick. Or as the evangelists say, it's a ministry. Like it's incredible. They'll say, oh, brother so-and-so, he's got the ministry of laying on of hands, or he's got the ministry of prophecy. But that's a gimmick, and the guys that have the gimmicks get the big meetings and do good.
Oh, glory, glory, oh, hallelujah, since I laid my burden down. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Age of 4, I had a decision to make. And I said, yes, Lord, I will.
Thank you, loving God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I dedicated my life to God. Praise the Lord. That night when she went home, that cancer had dissolved and run completely down her face. She was healed by the power of God. And the only thing that was left was a little irritation mark of little pink skin, but the skin was new like a baby. Hallelujah. Only because she believed. Hallelujah.
When I would go to a pastor's church where I hadn't preached before, and they'd sort of look me over and wonder, you know, what was I really going to say? What was I really like? And I'd sort of have to just cool it till I got up on the platform and they saw that I did say all the things they wanted
church.
To hear.
I have to tell you that all the churches I go to, you're my favorite church.
Well, you're really our favorite evangelist, but we don't want anybody knowing.
We don't want you to get a big header.
Yeah, we want to keep you humble.
Okay. Well, I've been kept poor so far. You know what I started to, you mentioned about Dallas, I was going to say, one thing I really like about coming to your church is the fact, you know, that the way that you treat me, and so honestly and financially, and my youth crusades. One church that I went to in Dallas, they, you know, gave me a rough way to go. It's amazing how many, you know, some preachers that there are. It's amazing.
Well, you know,
still,
you should have raised your boys.
There's so many preachers nowadays, so that
but you
can't only have them, you know, once, and after that. You can't have them back because they're not honest, and they don't treat the people right either, you know.
Yeah.
And if they don't treat the people right, then the people won't back them up.
Well, you see, that's the reason we have
you, Marjoe. That's one thing that we appreciate about your ministry. You've always blessed our people. You've been
they know when you
honest.
Tell them something, they believe it.
Yeah, that's true. I think nowadays people have seen so much, see so much happen. They can tell one of these shysters when they come through because they've heard everything, you know.
They know.
They'll listen a couple nights and they won't say anything, you know, but they can tell. After a while.
Yeah, they're not dumb. You know, people are intelligent nowadays. They
right.
There's one guy that gets into it so heavy that he prophesies, and he told me how he did it. He sat right, I mean, he looked right across the table back and forth at me, and he told me how, you know, how he confiscates money. He says he's on this station, it's over 40 states, and he'll go on there and he'll get on the radio and he'll say, I know that listening to my little voice tonight, that there's some lady out there and you've got $10 put away in a cookie jar. Now God spoke to my heart and told me to go and tell you to get that $10 and get it in the mail and send it to me, and God will bless you. God will give you a reward such as you have never known before. And then he comes back to me and he tells me, he says, if you're on the radio and you're going over 40 states and you're on at prime time, you've got thousands of people listening, the chances are that there are at least 200 or 300 little old ladies who've got a $10 bill in a cookie jar. And so if you even get, you know, if a couple hundred go over and get it and send it to you, that's $2,000 that you've made just like that. And so, you know, if you're going to get into big time religion, this is the games you've got to play, things like that. It's a you go into it as a business and you work it as a business, you know.
You know, he prints over 1 million magazines a month.
I mean, he sends out.
I know. He's got the biggest mailing list.
1 million. He has 1 million names and addresses, and he sends out magazines. Now, free.
Yeah. If you want to get started, he sells names off his mailing list. Mm-hmm. He's got so many all over the country. I know some other preachers.
I was talking to him.
They got mailing list from him.
He's got over 100,000 names in Southern California.
Melons and things.
Oh, in California.
Let Maryland serve.
My beautiful salad.
And I thought about getting that for the convention. I figured have them print it just sort of like his magazine.
Boy, they print that all on one sheet. You ought to see his presses.
I've seen them. He's got three big presses.
Yeah.
And everyone makes it with their magazine. You send out your magazine. The magazine, you show pictures of what you're trying to do, and then you raise dollars for projects, mainly the projects you do, like they raise money for missionary projects, say to go to Haiti, but they'll take in tens of thousands of dollars and maybe only spend a few thousand. So you work that as a business. Then you follow up from your magazine and your radio you use to build, and you go into one or two night crusades in auditoriums. And the crusades, you don't plan in the auditoriums, you don't make a lot of money from this, but it makes the personal contact. But the main money comes from the magazines and from the radio program, you know. But that's like a thing you've got to stay in it all the time. It's like the ones who are successful, they're businessmen who are constantly, they're like Madison Avenue PR men.
I want to go to Korea.
When are they going to go there?
Why don't you come keep our church in October while we go to Brazil?
I might do that.
Then I can go.
Okay, really?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, I want her to go.
I want to go too, though. How much property do you have over there?
Well, we bought 800 acres.
Thank you.
All jungle.
Have you developed any of it?
Yeah. We've got about... I'd say...
Anybody want some more salad?
We've got about 50 acres in cultivation. You know, rice, beans, corn.
Yeah.
And,
I heard something. What was it? About someone wanting to buy it? Or?
Yes, there's a preacher wanting to buy it. We're building a Bible school, and he wants to
then
buy
we got
it
a,
all of it.
We've got a deal with...
Project.
On with a big food company, you know. That makes corn flakes and stuff like that. Big mill. They want to buy it.
Part
a
of it
piece
all.
Of, well, a piece of property that I have, because I have a
would
waterfall
some of you
get and
out
$5 a
$5 or $10? Bring what you would for Jesus tonight. Come on.
I can't really think of a time that I ever believed in God or in, you know, and I've ever thought that it was a miracle of God that I preached. I don't think, even with all the people gathering around me, you know, thousands of people saying this has to be a miracle, surely, you know, God has called you and all that. I don't think with all that, I just, you know, knew that I could do it well and my parents had trained me, but I never really tripped out and thought that I was some real miracle
child. There's one guy that gets into it so heavy that he prophesies, and he told me how he did it. He sat right, I mean, he looked right across the table back and forth at me, and he told me how, you know, how he confiscates money. He says he's on, this station is over 40 states, and he'll go on there and he'll get on the radio and he'll say, I know that listening to my little voice tonight, that there's some lady out there and you've got $10 put away in a cookie jar. Now God spoke to my heart and told me to go and tell you to get that $10 and get it in the mail and send it to me, and God will bless you. God will give you a reward such as you have never known before. And then he comes back to me and he tells me, he says, if you're on the radio and you're going over 40 states and you're on at prime time, you've got thousands of people listening, the chances are that there are at least 200 or 300 little old ladies who've got a $10 bill in a cookie jar. And so if you even get, you know, if a couple hundred go over and get it and send it to you, that's $2,000 that you've made just like that. And so, you know, if you're going to get into big time religion, this is the games you've got to play, things like that. It's a you go into it as a business and you work it.
What do you want God to do for you?
He's
going to
do it right now.
Hallelujah.
Say thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Praise him. Say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise him tonight. Hallelujah. Oh, God is so real tonight.
Already saved, but they're getting the baptism. And someone will be standing there going, you know, and the poor person will be standing there and they're not saying anything. Then after a while, about four or five more will gather around and they'll start doing the same thing. You know, come on, speak it out. Till all of a sudden, the person will, you know, get so overwhelmed by the thing that they start going, you know, and the next thing, oh, that's it, you've got it. Like they feel good. We got another one, you know.
Tremendous, tremendous. He's a born preacher. He's just a preaching machine. But it's in the miracle of God. He is. And of God the body, no question.
Thank you, sweet Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Well, praise him.
I've watched certain rock performers perform, and a lot of things I do, you know, I've copied off of them or gotten in, you know, like Mick Jagger. Certain things that I do, I sort of do like a waist hunching thing that he does sometimes.
Lift up your hands and praise the Lord. We gotta watch out for these professional shouters. Can you say amen? Some people, I'll tell you, the minute the music starts, anyone that's in the spirit, you better watch out, because they gotta do the boogaloo or they gotta do the front. They got their own little thing. That's not the spirit, man. That's carnal. Come on. Hallelujah. You're not liking this, but I'm telling you the truth, and you know it.
I mean, if I was going to pick a religion of you know, Christian type religion, that I had to go into one of them. I mean, thank God I don't have to, but if I had to go into one of them, I would, you know, pick the Pentecostal faith, because some of the churches, the music is just great, and the people are interesting, you know, they're kind of weird, and it's okay, you know, it's...
I want every head bowed and every eye closed. Hallelujah. I just want to see the hands tonight. Did you play that song, He Touched Me?
I can't get up and say to them, okay, now listen, if you just believe this afternoon, I mean, it's all got to be done under the thing of Jesus, and which even that's okay, like, you know, the Jesus thing I would leave, but they still, I've got to put in that thing, like, if you don't come down, you're going to go to hell, and you're going to burn, and you've got to go into the sin thing. It's the way that I have to do it. If I could just do, like, the faith number and get up and say, okay, you know, everybody, let's really get loose this afternoon, and get off and get rid of all of our hang-ups and have nice group therapy, that would be great. But you can't do it that way. It's got to all be done under this facade of holiness.
For something happened. It's going to happen. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Well, praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
It's going on in our two lives. It's, you know, I just don't want to do it anymore. What can I say? Sometimes I feel like I should get up and do repentance to the audience or something, you know, which, like, I have these fantasies a lot of times, you go through, like, I'd really like to get up and just tell them what I really think, or where, you know, where I'm really at, or what I'd like them to do. Then when I get up, you know, I go right into my sermon. But things like this relieve my head at the time, but I've been playing with that now for a couple of years, and I just can't go on doing it like that anymore.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! He's free right now. He's pinned to that leg right now. God's setting him free right now. The doctor said he'd never do it. Over a year, it's been stiff, but tonight it's free.
Once that you get one or two that really come off and say, yeah, I really felt it, you know, I had a bad back or had a bad leg, then there's a host that say, oh yeah, I feel better too, because like 90% of it's psychosomatic.
I feel better.
Yeah.
That's right. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You know, God is going to do something for you. Then I'll turn around to the crowd, and I'll say, everyone, do you believe it? And, you know, everyone, say yes, you know. And I said, that's not enough. If there's no faith here tonight, I can't do anything. You've got to believe it. And I'll go, do you believe it? And then by this time, the crowds go, yes. And I'll say, sister, as I lay my hands on you, it's going to happen. By this time, you're just like this, you know, because I do a whole thing on you. Then, you know, I sort of like get down to, now I'm going to pray the prayer, and everyone bow your heads, and all of a sudden they go, in the name of Jesus. And I mean, by this time, that the shock doesn't get you. You know?
Thank you for the little children, Jesus. Hallelujah. Sister, the joy of the Lord's all over you tonight. Why don't you praise him? Say, thank you, Jesus. I believe he's going to touch you right now. Say thank you, Jesus. Sister, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, praise him tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise him tonight. Hallelujah. Oh, God is so real tonight. If you can't feel the Holy Ghost tonight, man, you're dead and you don't know it. So why don't you praise him? Why don't you call upon his name? Why don't you worship the Lord tonight? Oh, lift up your hands and praise him. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you. Right now, Jesus. Say Jesus. Say it again, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, brother, be loose. Be set free right now. That's right. Say Jesus.